As Minister of Service and L, I want to thank you for joining us for this information session. We are here today to discuss the legislative amendments that are being proposed in the House of Assembly. The amendments we are proposing will strengthen the enforcement of the Highway Traffic Act. These proposed amendments reflect our government's effort to support safe and sustainable communities. With me today is Ellen Duty, who is Registrar of Motor Vehicles. Ellen will assist in any questions at the end of today's session. I want to recognize a few people who are here today with this announcement. Chief of Police William James, the Royal Canadian Mounted Police Chief Superintendent Andrew Bowling, Acting Commanding Officer, Jackie Manuel, Chief Executive Officer of the Newfoundland Labrador Construction Safety Association, Jim Organ, Executive Director of Newfoundland and Labrador Heavy Civil Association, Darren Pike, CEO, Director of Education for the English School District, and Peter Smith, Director of Education with the French School District, and Len LaRich, President of the Safety Service NL, who have joined us today for this announcement. So thank you all for joining us here today. These amendments are proposed and aimed at enhancing the enforcement of laws that prevent the legal passing of school buses and prevent speeding infractions in school or construction zones. In addition, fines for passing a school bus that is stopped with red lights flashing are being increased. We have enhanced enforcement by making amendments that will allow a charge to be brought against the registered owner of a vehicle identified as breaking these laws, even if the driver cannot be clearly identified. These practices is consistent with other jurisdictions across Canada. At present, the law only allows officers to ticket drivers committing the offense. With this amendment, if a witness or video camera can positively identify a vehicle committing an offense, it should be much easier to successfully bring a charge forward. Registered owners will have access to two separate defenses if they can prove that either the vehicle has driven without the consent of the registered owner, or the individual was the registered owner at the time of the incident but was not entitled to possession of the vehicle, for example, a car rental company. As well, if during an investigation, the registered owner identifies the driver of the vehicle to police before a charge is laid, the police would have the option to lay a charge against the driver and not the registered owner. Demerit points will not be applied in the event of this type of conviction, as it is consistent with practices in other jurisdictions. As I mentioned, fines for passing a school bus that is stopped with its red lights flashing will be increased. The new fines will involve a minimum of $500 and a maximum of $1,200. Previous fines were in the range of $100 to $400. Those illegally speeding in school zones or construction zones will continue to face the range of $100 to $1,500. I want to note that this is double regular speeding fines. Once passed, these amendments would be effective 60 days after the bill receives royal assent. With the passing of these amendments, Newfoundland and Labrador will join British Columbia, Saskatchewan, Manitoba, Ontario, Nova Scotia, and Prince Edward Island in making provisions to changes the registered owner of a vehicle with traffic offenses. These legislative amendments will facilitate strong enforcement of the Highway Traffic Act and will help protect children and construction workers who can be especially vulnerable on our provincial roads. Road safety is everybody's responsibility, and I believe these amendments will contribute greatly to ensuring everybody's respect and responsibility.